Hello, dear citizens of India and the panel of judges. Speak India 2.0. Are we independent? Are we? If I look back to our bureaucratic structure, governing bodies, and enlightened judiciary, fundamental rights and duties at person, I question, is India really independent? Because trying to define independent is like trying to define within India. Even after 75 years of independence, it is a very big question to ponder to say we are independent. India has always set a wonderful example of being democratic, but everyone wants to be free from the regionalism and the stereotype that exists in every part of our country. So far, we have proved that Great Britain wrong for their wrongful disintegrated and rule in India. India is an emerging superpower, but even today, despite so many years of independence, there are some things that we are still lagging behind. There are few things that we still are the slaves of this modern India. And I would like to mention some few points that we still need independence, which is freedom number one, bad media and journalism. We are already in distress due to this pandemic, but there is another pandemic that is more dangerous and more lethal to our country. I'm obviously talking about bad media, which is busy preparing its own dish. The first in the list of ingredients is a sensational headline of cows similar to a glass one poem over it. Suspenseful and drilling music is played next at our special ingredient, China or Pakistan. As long as these media journals don't stop favoritism, it is difficult for us to become an independent. 2. Freedom. Number 2. Fake news and WhatsApp forward. Not only bad journalism, but we also need freedom from the fake news immediately. No matter what the subject is, the election votes, the attack in Pulwama, or the Citizenship Amendment Act, or Ram Mandir in Uttar Pradesh, or even the cure for COVID-19, you will get fake news on every subject, no matter which variety you ask for. It's almost like the job bazaar, you get whatever you ask for. We are now being taught a complete course on space as well. Point number 3, freedom from intolerance. As time goes on, our bodies are evolving. An additional element has been added, that is, the element of intolerance. No matter how much people argue in public, we never give a shit about it. But if someone is caught indulging in the public display of affection, and then if he tries to justify it by saying that it's okay, it's fine, then people beat the shit out of them. And it is not just an issue of love. We have suddenly become intolerant regarding several things. In short, if someone ever blesses the counter opinion in opposition to our opinion, then our first response is somewhat like be silent or else I will become violent. But this year on Independence Day, maybe we should listen to Gandhiji. We should ourselves try and be silent so that there is less of violence. Point number 6, the freedom of privacy. The concept of privacy is extremely difficult to explain in India. Everyone has to know everything about others. People in India are so free that they want to put their nose in everything. If we do not sprinkle the seasoning of gossip about others, our dinner remains incomplete. With my conclusion, speech, unity and diversity, I would like to mention it, in which we are lagging behind. Ever since India got independence, we are lagging behind unity and diversity. There is no unity and cooperation in this modern India with difference in opinions everywhere. We secured independence in 1947 and it's not like we have not achieved anything. As a country after independence, we have made our way to moon and stars and Mars, but despite this achievement, we are still draped in social and political loopholes that have enslaved us. And when we do have the freedom to free ourselves from these things, why are we silent? Let's transform our modern India into a really independent country. Thank you. Jai Hind.